This is chapter 15, class 7, visualizing solid shapes. Plane figures and solid shapes, we know that in day-to-day life, like books, balls, ice cream cones, all they have different shapes and they must have some length, breadth, height, some radius, and they all occupy space and they have certain dimensions. And these, they are called three-dimension shapes if they have 3D. Anything is 3D in the world. Even if you take paper, and that paper also has very little depth, but it is still a 3D. But the screen you are watching, this is described as 2D. This is 2D, two-dimensional space, because we only have this axis and this axis. So x-axis, y-axis. Until unless we have a z-axis, we can't say it is a three-dimensional space. So this is a cuboid, this is a cylinder, and this is a sphere, this is a cone, and this is a pyramid. And you can also match the two-dimensional figure. Why? Because what you can show on the screen or what you can draw on a paper, it will be regarded as a 2D, because we have only x and y in paper also. So this is a circle, this is a rectangle. And now, this is a triangle, this can be regarded as a square, and this can be regarded as a quadrilateral. Faces, edges and vertices. In this particular figure, all these corners are vertex. In plural, we say vertices. All the lines which are joining and they are culminating at these vertices, they are known as edges. And these are known as the faces. These are the 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, and if you count from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 flat square surfaces, these are the skin of the cube. And these are 12 line segments that form a skeleton of the cube, which are known as the edges. And these are the corner of the cube, which are known as vertices. So you can easily find out. I'll give you an example. Take this. How many faces we have? 4. How? 1, 2. Let me make this for you. So how many faces we have? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. 2 are hidden. So 1, 2, 3. Actually, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 1 is the base, 1 is hidden. So what if I can make this? How many vertices we have? 1, 2, 3 and 4 vertices. And how many edges we have? 1, 2, 3 edges. So let me count this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. So 4 plus 3. Let me make it again for you so that you understand it better. Okay. Edges are nothing but the lines. So we are joining this. As we have 1, 2, 1 hidden, 4, 4 faces. Now, how many vertices we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. So edges are the lines. 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 are there. Similarly, let us take this one. How many faces we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. And 2 are hidden. Faces are 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 are hidden. And one more is their base. So 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 5 plus 6, 7. 7 faces are there. For a cube, there are 6 faces, but one more face is there. Let us count the vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and one more is there, 10. Okay. So I hope that you are going to complete this all. Even these, see, cylinder, this, how we identify this? It has two circular faces. Similarly, in pyramid, we have one base. So we have these 1, 2, 3, there are 3 faces. In 1, 2, 3, 4, if you can see this also, 1, 2, 3 above and one base. Right? So, if you say, take triangle, it is a 2D. But if you make a pyramid out of it becomes a 3D. So we have nets. Nets for building 3D shapes. Nets are nothing but a shape or a plane figure, or you can say a skeleton, a sort of skeleton of 2D. This is in 2D. When we fold it this direction, see, we have folded it, it will form a 3D shape. If you can just join this, you will find a 3D shape of a cuboid. Similarly, if you can join this, you know, you just join this, it will form a cone. When you join this, it becomes a, means what you have to do is fold this and keep this on the top. Fold this, it will be a cube. Fold this or roll this, match it with these circles, it will be a cylinder. Take this one, take this one, take this one, take this one on these directions. This will be a pyramid. So you can say which is the tetrahedron. I'll give you a hint. Okay. How to draw solids on a flat surface? See, 3D, what you see is 3D. Everywhere things are in 3D. But how to show or how to present them such that the 3D illusion is there? So we ought to have a visual illusion. This is how we make it. This is an oblique sketch. How we drew it? This is an oblique sketch, because if I see it from the front, I'll see only this one. But if I see from here, my observer is here, he's able to see these two faces. Now we are able to make a 3D perception out of a 2D figure, but this is a 3D figure. We want to draw it in 3D. For example, how to draw it? Just take that we have a graph paper. You just have to draw this. Draw another one. And just join them. See? We just made this, joined it, and we just redraw this line in dotted. So this is the actual figure. This is the sketch. Actually, we have used only a screen, which is our 2D. But now you can perceive, this is an illusion, that now this is in 3D. So this is an oblique sketch. Okay. The size of the front face and its opposite are same. The edges which are equal in cube, they appear so in the sketch, though the actual measure of edges are not taken. Okay. This is an oblique view. Now there is another method by isometric sheet. You can draw using isometric sheet. Isometrics are nothing but the points which are equally distributed, only points are there. So if the dimension is 4 by 3 into 3, that is 4 length, 3 breadth and 3 height, how you are going to make it? So these are isometric sketches. In isometric sketches, these are dotted lines. If you want to draw sketches in which the measurements also agree with those of the solid, then you have to use the isometric sheets. If you use the oblique sketch, then the side may or may not match. So here, if we have to draw 4 by 3 by 3. So 4 is the length, 3 is the breadth. So let us draw the length and breadth. This is length. This is our, say, this is the height. So let us draw length and height first. This is length. So we took 4 dots. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 3 is the height. 1, 2, 3. Now, 3 is the width, this one. So we extend these with 3 points and now we join them. See, the final figure would be something like this. We have joined like this. So we connected the matching corners with appropriate line segments, and this is the isometric sketch of the cuboid. And we see the measurements are exact. If you take the oblique sketch, it may not be exact. So this is one more example how we can represent this with isometric sketch. If I can draw exactly like this, how I am going to draw this? First, I'll make this line 3. Okay, let me take any of these. Say this one 3. Then 6. Let me take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then what we have to do here is, let me draw this. Okay, let me extend it to the width, height and length we have used. Now 3 I am extending, 3, 3, 3 and now 3. Now let me join this. Okay, so this is how it should look like. So how many cubes we have? When you are able to visualize solid things, means those things which are hidden. For example, in this figure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These 6 cubes are available to us, or we can see it. But we can easily presume and we can anticipate that these 3 also have 3 cubes down below. So now how many cubes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 plus 3 which are below. So this becomes 9. How about this? 1, 2, 3 and 1 is hidden. So 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 are there. One this part is also seen. So now can you guess the number of cubes in this arrangement? See, you just have to count the first one. The other you can just multiply it by 2. These are 4 and these are 3. How many are there? 4 into 3. So 12. One base is also there. So 12 plus 2 is 24. How about this? The base is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6. Because these two also have, they are above these two, which are on below. So 1, 2, 3, 3 this, 3 this and 2 above. 6 plus 2, 8. How about this? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1 below this, so 9. Now when we combine the 2 cube or you know shapes, it will result in increasing the dimension. For example, in this example, we have 2 cubes of 2 by 2, means cube means all the sides are equal, 2 by 2 by 2. So if I combine this 2 cubes now, this is 2 by 2 by 2. When you combine this, the height and width remain the same, but the length becomes 4. How about this? Let us take this example. 3 cubes with length 2 cm edge. So let me add one more cube here. So what will be the length? Rest things will remain same. The length will be 1, 2, 3. That is 3 into 2, 6. 2 to 2, 6. So please try this. Now how to view different section of a solid? First is the slicing. If you take a bread and slice it, if you see a proper bread, it will be of the form of a cuboid. But when you cut, it will be in the form of square, but some height, you know, little bit of height. These are called the cross section. So there are so many things, you know, if you cut various things, you can just try it. You can cut this, see what happens, cut this, see what happens, what shape does it give you. If you take this, see this is a cone, if you cut like this, if you cut like this, if you cut like this, there are so many shapes being formed. See, ellipse. You can form ellipse, you can form circle, you can form a parabola, hyperbola. There is another way by shadow play, that if you just give some light ahead of this figure, you will see a shadow. This shadow is representing the view, that is the right in front of a cone we are putting. If you take an example of say 2 times, forenoon and evening, place a cup. See, your cup is going to show shadow here and this side the shadow will be like this. There is another way of looking by certain angles in different views. This is a front view of a house, side view of a house and a top view of a house. So this house is seen or viewed in 3 different way and it gives you an idea how it will look like. For example, if you see a building, the front view will be only this. The side view will be only this one. These 2 faces will be seen. The top view will be only these 2 faces will be seen. So this will be top view. If you combine this, if you see this, top view is this, the front view is this. And how about this one? This one? This is the side view. Only this face and this half face will be seen. When you see from the top, this one, this face and this face will be seen. So this will be the top view. So here is an example. Let us take this one. So if you see from front, 1, 2, 3, 4 means this will be seen. This is the front one. How about the top? 1, 2, 3. 3 faces will be seen. This is the top. And when you see from the side, 1, 2, this will be seen. This will be the side view. You can take any other example. Let us take this one. When you see from the front, only triangle will be seen. This is the front. When you see from the top, these two faces will be seen. This one, hidden one, and this one. So this will be the top one. And when you see from the side, only this face will be seen. So this will be the side. So what we have discussed, the circle, the square, rectangle, quadrilateral, and triangles are example of plane figures. The cube, cuboid, the sphere, this cylinder and cone, they are solid shapes. So plane figures are 2D or 2-dimensional. Solid shapes are 3D or 3-dimensional. The corner of a solid shape, they are known as vertices, line segments are edges, and flat surfaces are faces. A net is a skeleton outline of a solid that can be folded to make it. So same solid can have several different type of nets. A solid shape can be drawn on a flat surface just like a paper realistically, and we call this 2D representation of a 3D solid. So there are two types of sketches of solid which are possible. One is oblique, one is isometric. Visualizing is a logic also and skill also. You are able to, or you should be able to perceive the hidden faces. The different section of a solid, first is by slicing, second is by shadowing, and third is by looking at different angles, front view, side view, and top view. So this is all about this chapter, visualizing solid shapes. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.